people all over mid-America getting help because of those of you there caring and sharing. So many children, so many in need. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. So many people are coming to New Life Evangelistic Center at this time. Tell us your name.
My name is Jamika Hollis.
And why did you come?
I came in Larry Rice to get help.
Why did you need help?
I needed help because I have me a place. I just got to pay my deposit, and I have no funds for it.
And you have a little one, too?
Yes, I do.
And did you try a lot of other shelters?
Well, yeah, I did, and they told me I didn't have any space.
And so they all sent you here?
Yes.
And that's what we're hearing over and over. We're getting very crowded here at New Life Evangelistic Center. That's why we need you to pray for us, and that's why we need you to go to the phones and make your special gift now. New Life Evangelistic Center gets no United Way funding, no city, state, or federal dollars. We need to hear from you. Please call now, 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. There's a lot of women and children out there, aren't there?
Yes, sir.
A lot of women and children have nowhere else to
help.
Go.
No, they do not, and they need help also.
And over and over, this is where they're referred to, isn't it?
Yes.
And they're told that places are full. We can't leave the women out on the streets. We can't leave the children out on the streets. And we need you to help us to keep our doors open. So please go to those phones and please call, please care, and please share at this very critical hour. And it's not only the greater St. Louis area New Life Evangelistic Center is helping so many people. In Potosi, Missouri. Let's go to Larry Walburn.
Hi there, I'm Larry Walburn. I'm with the New Life Evangelistic Center Free Store in Potosi, Missouri. And not only do we have a free store here, but we have KNLP 89.7 FM, the Spirit of Potosi Radio. We have family shelters here. We have men and women shelters. And we also do a lot of emergency food supply through the pantry. We have a great supplier there. I want to give them honorable mention too, the YMCA of the Ozarks. Hallelujah. Without them, we probably couldn't feed an iota of the people that we do. So we do need, and we're coming up on the holiday seasons, we do need food items for holiday meals. So want to put that out to you. We also have another shelter back here that we're getting ready, and we need bunk beds for that. So if you know anybody that's got extra bunk beds or can donate a bunk bed of any kind, we need them. We need them bad. So we've got a lot of things going on here, but we want you to know that this is a ministry that reaches out to the community, not just locally, but for about three counties around. This is Washington County that we're in, but surrounding counties also come here. And we also have donations from other counties as well. So it's a big involvement. We're glad to be here. We know that time is short. Hell is hot. Jesus is coming, whether we're ready or not. We want to be about our Father's business. Thank you.
Levant.
And who's this?
Linda.
Linda. How did you end up coming to New Life Evangelistic Center?
Well, we was living on Haven in Minnesota, and our landlord, you know, had sold our building. And they, you know, had put us out and told us that we had to move. And we didn't have no funds or nothing available. So we've been calling shelters, and all of the shelters, you know, been filled, and they preferred us to come here.
So everybody's referring you to come
everybody's
to New Life.
Everybody's referring us to come here, yes.
And New Life gets no United Way funding, no city, state, or federal dollars. So if we're going to help, we need everybody to get involved.
Yes, because there's a lot of parents out there that's got kids that needs help that's been sleeping on the streets, yes.
Yes, a lot of them. What's your name?
DeAndre.
DeAndre. You're here with your mama too, aren't you? She's here.
Hello.
So many people right now. And how old are you?
Eight.
A lot of mothers with children coming in right now. And you said nowhere else to go?
Yeah, there's nowhere else to go. I've seen mothers, you know, sleeping parks with tents on them with the kids and stuff. And I tell them, you know, to go down to Larry Rice's, and maybe, you know, if they got space, they'll be glad to take you down there.
And we try to make space. Always try to find room for one more. Please get involved now and go to the phones and call. Become a Club 24 member for the sake of the children. It's 314-421-3020, 1-800-334-3276. Become a Club 24 member or call 436-2424 right now. Phone operator's there, 436-2424. Please call. And you go to school, do you?
school.
How do you get back and forth to school now?
Bus.
Does the bus come get you here? It's hard going from place to place. It's really hard. But we're trying to make it as easy as possible, but it's still very hard. And we ask you to please help right now. New Life Evangelistic Center is reaching out. It's dedicated staff and personnel. Perhaps you heard that Cyndee Walburn recently passed away, the wife of Larry Walburn, the co-founder of Potosi Work. But Larry's continuing that work. Let's go back to him.
Yes, this is Larry. And I want to thank everybody for their condolences and all the cards, the letters, the phone calls, and everything we got over Sister Cyndee going home, you know, to be with the Lord. And, you know, though I'm saddened from her not being here, I know that the work of the Lord that she has initiated here and is involved in is going to continue. So I know that the morning time here is because of the fact that she's not here anymore. But because she's not here anymore doesn't mean that the needs aren't here. So we appreciate anything you can do. We appreciate the help that we have gotten since then. And it all goes out to just say, you know, the Lord is gracious. The Lord is gracious and He is mighty. There will never be another Cyndee. There will never be another Cyndee. That woman was, ooh, hallelujah. But the time is short, like I said, and the work is here. The work is needed here. So we encourage you to get involved. Do what you can to help. In Jesus' name.
Please continue to pray for Brother Larry Walburn. He's continuing to reach out through the love of Jesus, even after his wife, Cyndee, went to be with Jesus. I'm asking you to please pray for him. And there still continues to be so many children and mothers that need help at this hour. What is your name?
Alicia.
How old are you?
Eight.
8 years old. You're here at New Life Evangelistic Center, aren't you? What did you think about when Mommy told you, hey, we don't have a house no more, we got to go down to the shelter? Did it scare you? It didn't scare you? Mommy, she helped you though, didn't she? She helped you find a place, didn't she? Yes. The children, the mothers, so many right now are facing needs. And again, we're not only reaching out throughout the greater St. Louis area, but all over Mid-America. Will you find it in your heart to help one more child? Remember, it's because of caring people like you that New Life Evangelistic Center is able to stay and keep its doors open, one of the last remaining walk-in shelters in Mid-America, that when mothers are in need, the hotline and everybody else tells them there's no room, they always try to find space for one more New Life Evangelistic Center. And that's only because of caring people. Will you get involved? Become a Club 24 member now. It's only 80 cents a day, $24 a month, for the sake of the children waiting on you to call. 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. Not only throughout the greater St. Louis area, but also Potosi, Missouri. Let's go back to Potosi.
My name's Connie. I'm from the New Life Evangelistic Center in Potosi, Missouri. We are focusing right now on continuing to help the community through food and clothes and just any needs, furniture, anything we can get. We are accepting donations of any kind, especially with the winter coming up. Our food pantry is starting to get a little short, so we're looking for donations for that, and we're just trying to carry on after my mother, Cynthia Walburn, passed away, who is the coordinator of this particular New Life. And we're just trying to carry on her legacy of all the people that she helped, and we want to continue on with that and not let that pass away with her. So if you guys want to come on down and help us in any way, volunteer, donate, even if it's time, like I said, food, clothing. And our phone number is 573-438-8201. You can call us anytime if you have just questions, need directions, want to know what we need help with, give us a call or come on down and see us. Our address is Post Office Box 173, Potosi, Missouri, 63664. And you can address that to the New Life Evangelistic Center or KNLP 89.7 FM radio. And like I said, just come on down and see us or give us a call and stop by. We'd appreciate it. God bless you and thank you.
My name is DeSalvo, and I came here about like 7 months ago, and I was turned around. And so I came to Reverend Rice's, and I'm here praising the Lord, and I'm thankful that I found this place. And also, we miss our Cyndee. She passed on the coordinator that used to be here. I'm just happy to be here.
Hi, I'm Eric Appleman, and
I just got here as of Friday from the city at 1411 Locust, and you know, I'm just grateful that God can help me in such a way to where I can have a roof over my head and a little bit of food in my stomach, and just to sustain myself. I know for sure that I'm a true witness to the fact that God will provide for his people. And I, like I said, I just thank God for Larry and Larry Rice and Reverend Larry Walburn and for giving me this opportunity to come and help out.
I want to thank the Lord for being here this morning. Thank the Lord for New Life Evangelistic Center. Thank you, Brother Larry, Brother Ray, them. I was down here with Sister Cindy and Brother Larry here for 7 years. I did a 2-year program here, and it was a blessing to me. Sister Cindy was like a mother to me. God knows she's been good to me. We had some ups and downs every now and then, but she kept me in line, though, you know. I thank God for that, and that's why I'm able to stand on my own now. I got a job now, and I'm working, and I'm paying bills and stuff, you know. And like I say, I thank God for Sister Cindy and Brother Larry and them, because it was a big help for me, you know, the time I was here. Like I said, I did 7 years here, and it was a nice 7 years, a beautiful 7 years I did here. You know, I did everything they told me to do and whatever. You know, I tried to help somebody along the way, too. You know, and like I say, I thank the Lord for New Life Evangelistic Center and Brother Larry Sister Cindy and the whole family, the Walburn family.
Not only is it Potosi, Missouri, but Joplin, Missouri, Van Buren, Missouri, Decatur, Illinois, Shelby, Illinois, Columbia, New Bloomfield, all over, Leavenworth, Kansas, just to mention a few of the places the Holy Spirit moving in a tremendous way, Marshfield, Missouri. And then I mentioned Springfield, Missouri. Richard, you came to us from Springfield, Missouri, didn't you?
Yes, sir.
You were homeless. How did you end up homeless in Springfield, Missouri?
My fiance kicked me out. So
there you were, homeless.
So I hitchhiked all the way to Springfield.
Wow. You know, there are a lot of homeless people in Springfield, isn't there?
Yes.
And I remember one man, Ron Moore, homeless man, in a house with other homeless veterans, and the house burns down and he dies. I mean, I remember a woman that died in a dumpster in Springfield. Four others earlier dying that were in a house. That were all homeless. There's tremendous shelter needs in Springfield, isn't there?
Yes, right. Yes, sir.
Did you sleep outside when you were in Springfield?
Yes, sir. I slept under a bridge.
You slept under a bridge.
For
how
about
long
four
did you
months.
Do this? Four months sleeping. What's it like sleeping under a bridge in Springfield, Missouri? What's it like?
It gets cold, windy. Rain comes in, gets you wet.
How did you end up coming to New Life Evangelistic Center?
Eric, he asked me if I wanted to join.
But you came to the day shelter there. You had the Veterans Outreach Center we had open all day.
Yes, sir.
How did you hear about that place?
A police officer told me about it.
Police officer found you under the bridge?
Yeah.
Told you to come down to that place?
Right.
Police refer a lot of people, don't they?
Yes, sir.
And so, some of them even sleep during the day in that place there, back
yes,
in the
sir.
Back there. Did you do that?
I did
that. They set up on cots back there.
Yeah, I did.
And then they have computers there, a place to do your laundry and a shower and even some food and a clothing store. Did you find that to be a blessing?
Oh, yes, sir.
It was a big blessing.
I didn't have anything when I got to Springfield.
So you were able to. And then they told you about a training program.
Yes, sir.
And you got involved in that training program. How is it changing your life?
It changed my very much. I got closer to God, met new people.
It's given you a brand new opportunity.
Brand new opportunity.
If somebody asks you, what has happened in your life during the past few months, how would you describe it?
I thought it was been real bad until I came in the program.
And how has it changed since you came in the program?
It made me very happy, and I like helping people. So
it's not only the men from Springfield, Missouri. There's also so many women that are now coming to the New Life Evangelistic Center. And again, people are coming from all over, and you're in joining us in giving people hope. So many have lost hope at this time. And New Life Evangelistic Center is in the business of providing hope. That's why your gift is very, very important. Just 80 cents a day, $24 a month. Please get involved and link up and be a partner now, a Club 24 member. And send that gift to New Life Evangelistic Center. Make a big difference for good. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. You can give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org and provide hope. Hope for the hurting, hope for the homeless. Tell us your name.
My name is Tanya.
Tanya, how did you end up homeless?
I was living with my son, his girlfriend, and their baby, and they put us out.
Where were you? Where are you from?
Union, Missouri.
And there's no shelters in Union, Missouri?
I didn't find any.
Did you try?
Mm-hmm.
What all did you try?
I tried the Agape House out there. They said that they were full.
Right.
And there was pretty much no other place that I could think of to try because
Franklin County.
I was new out there. So
Franklin County, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
No place. How many children do you have?
I have two.
Okay. How many places did you try?
I tried like at least six different places.
And how did you end up at New Life Evangelistic Center?
I had talked to a gentleman that was there that lived down the street from us, and he said he was coming through St. Louis, and he said he would be willing to bring me and my children here to New Life.
How has it changed your life?
Actually, I'm a little bit more happier, but I want to get on my feet even faster.
Amen. But you got involved in the transitional housing program.
Yes.
You stayed for shelter. We all gathered, and we just had prayer. We had communion.
Mm-hmm.
Are you growing spiritually?
Yes.
You feel like this is helping you get closer to
the
Lord?
Yes, it is.
Do you have more hope now?
Yes, I
do. Tell us about what kind of hope you got.
I've got more hope to hopefully find a job. You know, I'm ready and just willing to go, you know, just maybe hopefully find housing for me and my children.
For you and your children right now.
Yeah.
And you've been trying a lot of places.
Yeah.
There just isn't that many places people can just walk in and get shelter anymore, can they?
No.
Just not places like that. I mean, yeah, their agencies still do a good job out there, but they don't have to walk in shelters anymore like they used to, like the Salvation Army used to do. Mm-hmm. You just don't walk in there anymore like that. You know, the greater St. Louis area, they give you a hotline number, and you call that hotline number, and what do they tell you?
They tell you that they're full.
They always tell you you're full, and that's what they do. So we're the place that, you know, you don't need to call no hotline. You don't need no referral. If you're homeless, New Life Evangelistic Center is helping, but we're getting more and more crowded. We need churches. If I could just find one church, just one church that would pray and say, look, Larry, we'll come by, we'll pick up your overflow at 10 o'clock at night. We'll send our church bus, and we will open up our church building, and we will take the homeless in there. Now, some folks say, well, what will the neighbors say about that? When you preach, you tell people out here, don't worry about what the neighbors have to say. Why do you do it as a church? Do what Jesus said. Aren't we more worried about what Jesus said? He said, when I was hungry, did you feed me? Naked, did you clothe me? Sick or in prison, you visit me? A stranger, homeless, did you welcome me? So after you've done to the least, he said, even so you've done to me. Matthew chapter 25, Word of God. There's all kinds of scriptural mandates that tell us we need to be doing this. And then Jesus said, foxes have holes, birds have nests, but he, the Son of Man, had nowhere to lay his head. We need to help those that are in need. Couldn't find a single church in Franklin County that opened its doors to you?
No.
Couldn't find them anywhere.
There was one right down the street, and they told me they couldn't help.
Couldn't help. What'd they do?
They just pretty much sent me on my way.
We got to do more than just preach on Sunday mornings. Now, you want to get mad at me about it? Get mad at me about it. Say what you want, anything you want. In fact, you can talk about me all that you want, as long as you're on your knees. But I want to live by the book. Now, it takes faith to live by the book. It can't be business as usual. Just preaching a sermon, bringing out the security, calling the police if they don't leave after church, dragging them out of church, and then drag them in. It's got to be more than that. It's got to be more than that. And we'll help your church get started to live by the book, to do what Jesus told us to do. Now, again, if you can't do it that way, then how about providing a meal? And bring it to the New Life Evangelistic Center closest to you, whether it's in Springfield, Potosi, St. Louis. Get involved. Please, we're an interdenominational center, and we're there to help you, help the people in the church, and help the people on the street, to be a bridge between the man and the woman in the street, and the man and the woman in the pew. Again, Christ offers us hope, all of us, so we can't just talk it any longer. Talk is cheap. The supply is greater than a man. We've got to let Christ's light and love flow through us right now. If New Life Evangelistic Center had not tried to live by the book, what would have happened to you and your children?
I probably would have lost my children to the state. And I don't know where I would have been.
What would that have done to you as an individual?
I don't know. I really don't.
So there comes a time when you need more than just somebody preaching to you that God loves you, and you need more than just somebody saying, pray, be of good health, and go on down your way. You need somebody to do that. I think in the James talks about something like that. Yeah. So you need it something more than that.
Yeah.
Help them understand why you need it something more.
I really can't really describe it. It's difficult to describe what, you know, how I feel about a lot of things.
Well, feel free to. Just, you got a lot going on inside of you, right? And there's a lot of pain, a lot of hurt in there. But in the middle of it all, he wants you to know that God loves you. You're not just a client here. You're part of a family. Do the other ladies tell you that? Did they tell you that you're going to make it?
Yeah.
That God hasn't forgotten about you? That he loves you? I asked for a church to open its doors. I say, well, we can't do that. Well, can't you take this woman and her children? And how old are the children?
8 and 6.
8 and 6 and adopt them? Come on, you preach about evangelism. This is evangelism in action. Don't just continue to give a lot of God talk out there, which is only going to damn you further in the pits of hell, because the scripture says to him or no, to do good and do it to not, it's a sin. And you're living in as much sin. You can preach against homosexuality. You can preach against abortion. And the Bible tells you that the greedy and the self-serving will be damned. You know, so preach about these little things that, and they're not little, but these things that are big issues in society. But preach two things that you think you can get on and forget the rest of it and be awakened on the last day and hear the Lord Jesus Christ himself tell you, I never knew you, because when I was hungry, you didn't feed me, naked, you didn't clothe me, sick or in prison, you visited me, stranger, you didn't welcome me, as often you've done to the least of these, said, even so, you've done unto me. And you tell this woman you don't have room for her in her heart. You tell this woman you don't have room for her kids, and you leave her out on the streets. You take it up with Jesus, because we're bringing you that opportunity right now. You probably turn the channel at this moment and entertain yourself somewhere else. Go for it. That's on you. But Bible tells me in the book of Ezekiel that if I don't warn you, the blood's on my hands, and if I do and you do nothing with it, the blood's on your hands. So you better take it up with the preacher. You better take it up with the deacons. And there are deacons on the board that get some used canned goods and open a used clothing store and help a few little people. That's wonderful. But get involved. Open the church to the homeless like Jesus told you to do. Or at least take this woman and her children. Find them an apartment. Get them set up in a place. Minister to them through the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And love them and help them and get involved. It takes faith. It takes faith. How would that make a difference in your life?
It would actually change a lot of things.
How would it change something?
My children would be a lot more happier, and I would be too.
They'd be a lot happier. And you'd welcome a church. You'd welcome any church that stop preaching and start living it, right?
Yes.
Amen. That's what Jesus told us to do, didn't he? He said, don't just be a hearer of the word. He said, be a doer also. So keep on preaching, keep on preaching, keep on preaching, keep on giving more and more knowledge. 1 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 1 says, knowledge puffs up, and you got a whole puffed up congregation. That's your congregation. Love builds up. And as soon as the first crisis comes, and as soon as they end up homeless, are they going to come back and find any shelter in your church? I pray they will. Knowledge puffs up. 1 Corinthians chapter 8, love builds up. Now, you might say, well, preacher, you're not being very loving, you're being judgmental. I'm not judging anybody. I don't even know you out there, and I don't even know who's hearing this, if anybody. But I just know that if I don't say it, I don't want the Lord someday to tell me, you didn't warn him, you didn't say it. Here's what I put on your heart, Larry. Here's what I've shown you on a daily basis. I show you this woman, I show you these children, and I think of John. John, with his little girl and his little boy. He puts his little boy in daycare, takes his little girl out on a job and looks for a place day after day after day. John's trying to find a place to work. He sleeps in the lobby of our place every night. Church could adopt him too. There's a lot of people hurting out there. A lot of people hurting. And you can make a difference in somebody's life if you'll get involved. And get involved and start living out the word. Give us a call. Write me. Sign your letter. Say whatever you want. Larry Rice, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. If you got a different perspective, I'll be happy to hear it. Even read your letter on TV. That's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Want to get involved? We'd love to hear from you. www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Or you can go to, you can write me, as I mentioned. You can call us 1-800-334-3276. There's so many people that are hurting right now, and they need some help.
My name's Bill Maddock. For years I had been seeing little images in my spirit and in my heart about being homeless, and I would congratulate myself about avoiding it and even thank God for something, for delivering me from something he wanted me to do. And the situation just got so intransigent that I couldn't get out of it. I had been driving a 21-year-old van and had 35, 40 miles one way to go to work, no bus lines. And it finally got to the point where it couldn't be driven on the highway anymore, and I couldn't get to work. And they kept putting off letting me off of the payroll, and I kept trying to do the right thing and calling in saying, look, I can't get there. How can we get off this square, basically? I had to stop calling in before they'd let me off the payroll, and then they said I abandoned the job. So I have no income, and I basically, when it got to that point, I gathered belongings and started walking. And I got to a particular bus stop, finally, and I was sitting there at the bus stop thinking I had no money. Well, somebody pulled up in an SUV, gave me a dollar. And that prompted me to re-examine the contents of these little pouches here, and I found four quarters. So now I had bus fare to get partway downtown. I told my story to the bus driver, and they gave me a transfer, and I was able to ride all the way to Locust Street, and I walked from there. And today, we just got these. This is important, folks. Mm-hmm. This is important. The Forgotten's call. The church is called to care for the underprivileged, to care for the widows, to care for the homeless, the orphans. That's the Forgotten. Don't forget us. We are out there. We are not all criminals. Most of us don't do drugs, don't do alcohol. We're just very cold. We need help. We don't like to ask for it, but we need it. So please, open your hearts. And if you're running a church, I have to ask you a question, and this hurts. Why are you locking your doors when your treasure is supposed to be in heaven? Why do you lock your doors on earth? So many people could sleep in those pews and sleep in those aisles. Why don't you open the doors and let them do it?
Amen. And to help you get the word through, we'll make copies of this available, this newspaper right now, 12 pages, and it's absolutely free of charge, and we'll make enough copies available to every member of your congregation if you'd like it. So just call us and tell us how many of these you'd like. We'll send you a couple of them. Postage's kind of expensive. Do more than that, you'd have to come by and pick up the rest, and we'd be happy to give them to you. And again, give us a call, 1-800-334-3276 and 421-3020. Tell everyone your name again.
Bill Maddock.
Okay, Bill, you hit on a very important point. We could sleep on the church pews. I think you heard me earlier, and you feel kind of strong about this. Tell us what's on your heart.
Well, you know, I have been involved in a lot of churches before. Maybe some people would say too many churches, but I've been involved in churches that have grand cathedral-like sanctuaries. But when the service is over, the doors get locked.
And if they're big enough, they have security guards on duty to be sure you're out of there, going from room to room.
Right. And when I came down here, I found at least, well, I found your place, obviously, but I found at least one other place that normally leaves the doors open. Praise God.
You can get in the middle of the day, go in and pray at least, okay?
Yeah.
Amen. And you know, and if they want to open up their church to help the homeless, we will help you get the blankets, and we'll even send some staff to help train your people. But we need a miracle right now. We got to find one somewhere. 1-800-334-3276, 314-436-2424. You can write me at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166. If you call, I happen to be out visiting different centers. Ask for my son, Chris. This is very dear to his heart also, Chris Rice. And we'll get in touch with you and just really try to help you do what Jesus has told all of us to do. You know, they're kind of shocked. At least recently they came out with a report that 20% of Americans now call themselves like the unaffiliated. Many of them are spiritual, want to get close to God, but they don't want to be associated with any one particular church. I think that 20% is looking for a church that's willing to take action rather than just talk. Would you not say?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you get into churches that have good doctrinal teaching, but what do they actually do? You know, I am experiencing humbling right now. That's probably the one area that is weak in my Christian education. I've never had to pay a dime. Yeah. God has made sure that I have had some wonderful, powerful teaching, seminary-level teaching for free. But none of it involved actually being humbled and having my balloon burst.
Right. But knowledge puffs up. Love builds up. Folks, remember that now. And listen, if you're just going to get more and more biblical knowledge, you're just going to bring yourself under greater and greater biblical judgment. So just listen to the tapes, get the teaching, try to get it up here. Well, you're just setting yourself up because you got to act on what you know. And the Bible tells us to him or her know to do good and doeth it not, it's a sin. And so let's stop living as sinners and let's start serving Jesus. Now, there's a lot of things he haven't teach me on. Now, there's things he may have shown you. I need to learn. That's why we need to come together, work together, pray together, and address this issue of homelessness. We can eliminate homelessness one church at a time. Will you get ready? Will you get busy? Will you do it? You can write me, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166.